So today we're doing something a little different. I thought I'd do a what's in my dance bag. It's slightly, only very slightly different to normal because COVID. I just thought it'd be interesting. Anyway, I'll just start. First off, because we're not allowed to change, I'd be wearing my dance kit when I get there. So I do not have any dance kit at all in here. And then usually, because of everything that's going on, I would also have a mask in here. We have to wear outside the studio, then when we go in we get to take it off. And also I bring hand sanitizer and just one of these. They have sanitizer there anyway. They have these really cool, like, put your thumb in this. It's cool. It's got the dance school's logo on it, and I saw that in last September and I was like, oh. Anyway, then because we aren't really allowed to roll around on the floor, we have to bring, well, you're meant to bring a yoga mat. I do not have one. Should probably get one. I've wanted one for ages anyway, for at home, but I used this old camping mat. If anyone is looking into getting a yoga mat for dance or anything, I'm just going to give you a heads up. If you have to pull it out and put it away more than once, don't get it in one of those long bags because it's a handful. Ones with like strings like this, or they have like strings like this and a loop so you can carry them, those are great because you just fold them up as tight as possible and easily. Hair stuff. Really, you know, do your hair before arriving. Like, normally anyway, I mean. But just in case something goes wrong. Our studio for all dance stars have to wear our hair in a bun. I know most places like have your hair tied back, and then for ballet you have to have a ballet bun. So I have hairbrush. And then in here I just keep, oh gosh, I don't know where to start. It's a mess in here. Right. Oh my. So it's just playing one of these. And then I have one of these divider things, and what I keep in them is hair nets or buns. I have different sizes and different colours. Basically, they're just ones that I have that have not fallen apart. Actually, that's a lie. Most of them have fallen apart. There's huge holes in quite a few of these. I have quite a bit of hair, so I have some that are really small, and some that are really big. So, for example, this one is fine, I just double it. But for the small ones, I put two on, just because otherwise my hair still goes flying. My hair still looks like a mess. I have a lot of hair ties, and I mean a lot. So I have it in this colour because my hair used to be a lot more blonde when I was growing up. So these are just kind of the ones I automatically have. I also just have some like really rough spare ones. But these are the ones I get. clue. Is that showing up? I hope it is. But they have no... I'm guessing it's called a snag because this says snag free. So like none of the metal bit on it. I have hair ties that match my colour. But I'd only use these for like shows because then I have some good hair ties. So I've just got two of those in there. Now I have two types of hair pins. In this one, I have these wide ones. These are the ones I use the most for my bun. I have a random safety pin. Ones of these. I've got these ones are really good. They're really thick. They're very strong. But I also have ones like this that I got because I think I was running out and they're useless. I also have this small long one which just has loads of thin clips like this, so for like flyaways or if I do the entire thing in a rush then I realize I have a bump, like one of those, I just pin it down. It's okay, I just locked my sister out in the rain. So then I just have my shoes. So I've got my jazz ones with a hole in it because I wear through these ones really quick. But this is from SoDanca. But most of them really annoy me because they have really solid backs but these, they're comfortable. They don't bother me. So that's why I have these ones. Then I have my tap shoes. They have insoles because they don't fit. And then on the bottom, you can see they've been used for many years because I have split them. I have newer ones, they're just too big, so I stick to these. Yeah, moving on to my ballet shoes. So I store my ballet shoes. This is for like, I believe cheer shoes. But it's really solid and it's got these like air holes so my shoes can breathe. And it's very convenient because can just, if I only had ballet for example, because floor work is non-existent, so it'd be really easy. Also it's got the noisiest zip. We've got my softbox. I got these before everything started happening, and then, so I haven't worn these much. In case you're wondering how I figure out which foot is which, this is just a random one in case people get confused. I'm sure everyone's figured this out by now, but your big toe is where it's more worn out. Well, at least it should be, if you're doing it correctly. They are from Bloch. Also, in case you don't actually do ballet, softbox basically look like pointe shoes except they're soft and you don't go on your pointe in them because that would hurt. I have my pointe shoes. My pointe shoes are also from Bloch. These have got cushion at the bottom of the pointe. I've darned the bottom instead of using like they have like stick on things, but I prefer this. These ones to figure out which way. I have sewn, or actually no, my mother has, an L onto the left. there's nothing in the right one. So that's how I figured that out. Then I have these ouch pouches, like material ones. This is just the me thing. I don't like these because, like, they're fine at the beginning, but after I've worn them for a very short amount of time, I can feel like the seam. I can feel it, which is odd, because they're not like completely dead. I have these. These are silicone ouch pouches. Now, I've only worn these for, I believe, twice for like at most 15 minutes in total. But they're just basically silicone versions. These, how do I put it? They are very good, and they seem to become one with the shoe. Like, you can feel what's going on. It doesn't feel like, it feels like you've basically just put your foot into the shoe without an ouch pouch, except for you get the comfort of an ouch pouch, and there's no seam, which is good for me. But yes, I think these are silicone ones. Yes. That's a very dirty. This is my bag. Well, it's kind of dirty box. It's got dead flowers in this. But they asked us to bring a box, so I'm guessing because, you know, fabric and, you know, you're not allowed chairs and all that. So we have to bring boxes. Most people bring like boxes this, like, half the size. The reason I bring one so huge is my mat fits perfectly. This is the box that I use for my dance shows and stuff that I've always used, because instead of, it's easier to see instead of a bag when you've got all your costumes and it's all laid out and you can see it, especially when it's transparent. If you have like paralleled up, you can see it, although I've got to be honest, it still gets messy. Thank you for watching. I'm now going to go and have lunch. Please like, subscribe, you know, leave a comment. I'm hungry, I'm gonna go eat. Okay, bye.